Welcome to Elite Tempest Spine. At level, I'm level 12 right now. And this is the first life. Number 6, I think, 6th installment of the first life video I'm doing of the Gingerspyce build. And just gonna go over a couple of equipment changes since my last video. I've upgraded the frozen tunic to the level 12 version. And added bleed to my scimitar as well as the wolf collar. And I think that is the only equipment change. The shield is up to plus 5 invulnerability now. Also picked up a wall of wood off the auction house for a decent price. They used to be really low back when that chain, after that chain was had been around for a few months. But now I think people are running it less, so you know they used to be down to like 40k, but I got this one up for about 100k. But you can easily farm it if you don't want to buy it. You can run the chain just on heroic, and it's usually in the end reward list for the chain, but not guaranteed, but it's pretty common. And for feats, I picked up Empower Spell. Extend turned off right now because I'm not gonna need it in here. Lots of shrines just to save mana, and I'm gonna have keep the wolf parked there for this first part. Now, I did sort of a partial dry run before this, and one of the problems I had is the hill giant casters are casting destruction, and even on a save, I took 400 damage, and I can't survive that. So it's going to require a little bit of luck. If I get hit by a big destruction, then I'm not going to be able to do it.
Thank you.
fire giants don't like creeping cold. That was just regular creeping cold. You can watch his health bar. Goes down pretty quick. Didn't even have to use greater creeping cold on him. So here, this requires an 18 intelligence, so I only have a base 10. So I got a plus 6 cloak of the auction house, and I've got one lasting elixir of supreme ability. So I can get that rune. Luckily, I still had those on Ginger from a daily roll a while ago. So that was a single SLA of produced flame. Just did over 800 damage to the ice flinzer. And that is maximized and empowered. So here's where you gotta kill the ice flinzer and the fire reaver at the same time. So we try to pull the ice flinzer back a bit. That was close. If I kill him right about this intersection, that should give me plenty of time. Greater Creeping Cold will take care of the Fire Reaver. Piece of cake. They dispelled my resist fire. Greater Creeping Cold and Creeping Cold are a Fire and Forget spell. You can just hit the mob and run away. You don't have to worry about it. It's more than likely going to die, especially with Greater Creeping Cold. Once it's an unusually strong mob. my wolf before I rested. Now if you're doing this with a party, here's where you want to throw a grease right here, so when they come out, they all go sliding down the mountain and get mad at you. And then squelch you and scream at you over mic. It's pretty entertaining. So this is the way you want to go after coming through there, instead of going in a big circle like I just did. I really should have rested before coming here. Super close. Have the wolf run distraction on the beholder. This is one of the things they're going to fix. The wolf doesn't want to attack it when it's so far away. I think this is coming in U23. All that with what, 150 mana? Not bad. Although it was super close. Let's give the dog a couple buffs. He earned it. I still haven't eaten any stat tomes on this team, other than the free skill ones. Tried to get some cheap ones off the auction house, but somebody keeps outbidding me. But there was a whole bunch of them on there for like 5-6k plat. Bell of opening for this. Creeping cold and produce flame, great for mobs that have evasion, because those spells cannot be evaded. too low. But the wolf is not. Show you the regular produced flame. This is unmaximized, unempowered. So it's hitting low 200s on a non-crit, about 100 on a crit, and about 100 on a non-crit. So that's pretty decent for a spell that costs 6 spell points. It's unmaximized and unempowered. Let's see if we can find another. One more skulking about. Here we go. So here's the, this is the amped up one, the SLA. Still hit for only 200. Huh. Oh, that was a non-crit though. You can actually have your wolf do this, but he's probably gonna get smoked. I got his trap saves up, I think as high as they can go right now though. Okay, he was struggling with that one. Try it again. There we go. Pretty sweet. Heavy load. Goodbye, plate mail. Show you what the wolf's DPS looks like around this level. Just get him on the black guard. So it helps. Thank you. buffs. Nope. Alright, well maybe we can have the dog tank sorjek. See how that works out. If I get flung off the mountain, there's gonna be about 5 minutes of this video edited out. Got the electrical absorption boots going on, so that would help. That will help in here. Eye on the dog's health. Wolf is a champ. Ha! That sucks. He's going down too. That was incredible. What an outstanding finish to this video. So that is elite at level Tempest Spine. I won't bore you with me running back up there to get the loot. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions about my build, feel free to respond to my forum post. You can respond to my videos on YouTube. And if you're on Sarlona, you're more than welcome to send me a tell.